Hey everyone, it's Jess and welcome back to my channel. I am having an interesting hair day. Let's just leave it at that. I don't know what my bangs are doing. They are long, they're in my face. Anyway, today I'm bringing you guys a brand new review and tutorial. And today I am reviewing for you guys the new ColourPop Celestial collection. So this is just one of the two mini collections. I am going to be reviewing the products that I picked up today for you guys, telling you guys my thoughts on them, and then also giving you guys a tutorial at the end of how I created this look on my face today. First things first, let's break it down into the two sub-collections of the Celestial collection. On the one hand, there is the Solstice collection, which is packaged in green, and then the other half of the collection is the Equinox collection, which is packaged in this pinky purple. Each collection includes one 9-pan eyeshadow palette, which retails for $14, a pressed blush, which retails for $10, and two luxe glosses, which retail for $8 each. This collection is currently an Ulta exclusive, so if you're interested in picking anything up, it is on Ulta's website only. Sorry, non-US friends. I did pick up the entire Solstice collection to show you guys today, so let's jump ahead into my thoughts on these products. Let's start with the She's Got Solstice eyeshadow palette. Now, I have a lot of opinions on this palette. I think the first one let's talk about is the packaging. I think the packaging is beautiful. It matches all of the other green Solstice packaging in this collection. So it has this green, yellow, and almost like purpley tie-dye spacey looking thing. On the inside here, the shades are also pretty and they kind of match with the theme. So you have kind of the pinky, rosy, peachy brown shades, and you also have a pop of green and some pops of gold. There are five mattes in this palette. So these two, and this one. Three shimmers, and then a foiled shade. And what I found super unique about this palette is that for the first time in a long time, ColourPop released a palette with absolutely no eye warnings, which means all of these shadows in this palette are safe to use on or around the eye area. I know in the past there have been foiled shadows or glitter shades that aren't safe to use on the eyes. I use them that way anyway. Beside the point, this one is completely safe for your eyeballs, so that's a plus for ColourPop. I think this palette is perfect for creating a bright, neutral eye, nothing too in your face, but still really bright and springy. The first shades I want to touch on this palette are the matte shades. I felt like they blended really well, they blended super well, and overall they just performed as ColourPop mattes should. I felt like they're nothing out of the ordinary with those. The shimmers are where I started experiencing a little difficulty, which you'll see a little bit in my tutorial later. I've tried all three of these shimmers at different times. I've been using this palette on and off for the past couple weeks. This bottom green shade I haven't really had any issues with. It's more of these two that I've run into the problems with. So both of these are on my eyelid today, and every time I use these shades, they just don't like to stick to my eye. I've tried it with concealer bases, I've tried it with eyeshadow primers, glitter primers. Every time I've used these, I've had to go back in with my finger, which I personally don't mind. I actually like doing my shimmers with a finger. I just think the brush is more precise in application. So I wouldn't use this for like a cut crease or something if I couldn't get it right on where I wanted it. This foiled shade right here, Super Stardust, also gave me a similar issue. I really had to dig my brush in to get it to pick up anything, and then I really had to go over it multiple times to really get that gold flake to show. To achieve my gold inner corner today, I actually used my Morphe E36 brush just to kind of poke in there and then apply it right on the inner corner. I felt like that was the most effective way of getting it to show up on my eyelids. I felt like every other way it didn't work. If I put it on my finger, it just stayed on my finger and wouldn't transfer onto my eyes. So overall, I was not a fan of the foiled shade right here. The shimmers were okay. They weren't my favorite from ColourPop, but I really do like the mattes. I think I would recommend this palette to anyone that's already familiar with ColourPop's formula, maybe wants to try something new or add a new neutral palette to their collection. I definitely don't think it's awful. I actually really enjoy this palette. I just feel like it's a lot of work to get it to where I want it to be. Next up, we have blushies. I picked up both blushes, so the one from each collection. This first one is Interstellar. This is from the Equinox collection, and this one's more of like a mauvey rose blush. It reminds me a lot of the blushes from the Making Mauves collection from ColourPop. I have not used this one yet, but I have used the other one. This is the Meteor Bright blush, and this one is a terracotta peachy orange shade. I was really nervous when I first saw the color of this blush. I'm very, very fair-skinned, so a blush like this, when I look at it, my first reaction is that it's going to totally oversaturate my face. I did pick up both blushes because I was nervous about that and I knew I wanted to film this video, but I actually really like this blush. I feel like it looks a lot lighter on the skin than it does in the pan. It is what I have on my face today, and I found myself reaching for it in other makeup looks all week, so I've really been enjoying this one. I think their blush formula is phenomenal. If you haven't tried them already, they have some of my favorite pressed blushes, and I think they're really worth the $8. They are so good for the price point, and I absolutely love their blushes. The last item I want to touch on today, this is the ColourPop Luxe Gloss. I will be honest, this is what I was most excited about in this collection, and I think this is the item I liked the least out of everything. I love glosses. I just feel like this wasn't my cup of tea. Normally when I wear glosses, and I wear glosses a lot, I like very light feeling glosses, ones that aren't super sticky on my lips, ones that glide, I don't get stuff stuck in them, they last a long time. I think my favorites are the Fenty and the Pat McGrath glosses. For the price, I think these are great. $8 is super good for a gloss. I think that's a great price. I just don't love the formula. I think the first thing that really turns me off of these is that it has like a passion fruit kind of smell, a very tropical fruity smell, and I am just not a huge fan of that. I also don't really like the texture. I feel like it's very thick and heavy feeling on my lips. I do feel like they're hydrated, so I don't feel like it's getting dry on my lips. I just feel like it's a lot. On the plus side though, I do like that you can do one coat of gloss for a more sheer effect and a second coat of gloss for a more opaque effect. And I like to pair my glosses with a lip liner, so I've been pairing this one with the Bodyography Barely There lip liner. So a nice brown nude one, and it seems to be working out super good. It's what I'm wearing today. I would recommend this if you are a lips person, if you love glosses or love lip products. I think this would be a fun one for you to try out. I definitely think it's worth a try. I do think I'm going to be picking up more shades of this in the future. I just don't think it was my favorite gloss of all time. Before we transition into the tutorial portion, I just wanted to say a quick thank you for listening to my thoughts on these products. I hope you guys enjoyed and maybe learned something, maybe it gave you a better understanding about this collection. If you haven't already, I would hope you consider subscribing so you never miss out on a video, and I will see you guys all next time.